a bridge fuel better than coal, or nothing but the last gasping breath of the fossil fuel industry? That's right. Today at Student Energy at UC Davis, we're talking about natural gas. Natural gas is a hydrocarbon gas that's mostly made of methane, or CH4. It is a non-renewable fossil fuel energy source that is used for heating, cooking, and generating electricity. Across the globe, natural gas accounts for about 23% of electricity generation. The US government started supporting the industries in the 1970s, largely in response to the Arab oil embargo. They invested heavily in research and development and established tax credits that jump-started the natural gas development.
By combining horizontal drilling and hydraulic fracturing, also known as fracking, the U.S. has increased its output of natural gas and oil by 57% over the past decade and is now the world's largest producer of both. Because natural gas is a cleaner fuel than coal, it was also promoted by the Obama administration and some environmentalists as a key strategy to cut carbon dioxide emissions. While it's true that burning coal emits nearly twice as much carbon dioxide, natural gas is still a deadly fossil fuel that's largely incompatible with a decarbonized energy system. From a carbon dioxide point of view, natural gas is far worse than technologies like wind, solar, geothermal, hydropower, and nuclear.
Most natural gas is produced by fracking, which uses immense amounts of water during production. Fracking frequently contaminates the surface and groundwater, affecting the drinking water supply and public health of rural communities that are located close by.
When natural gas is burned in power plants to produce electricity, it impacts the air quality in surrounding communities. That's because burning natural gas produces nitrous oxides and other volatile compounds that form ground-level ozone, which is harmful to people's health. Power plants are typically located in disadvantaged communities, and the effects are disproportionately borne by Black, Indigenous, and Latinx communities. Over 1 million African Americans live within a half a mile of a natural gas facility. In fact, in California, the leading cause of premature death from combustion pollution is now natural gas use in buildings, not cars or power plants. Finally, the deadly pipeline explosion in San Bruno and other accidents around the country show that running highly flammable gas through our communities will never be 100% safe, no matter the precautions. Look outside. Climate change is here, and it's only just getting started. As a historic leader in carbon emissions, the United States has a responsibility to stop burning fossil fuels, including the ones that are less bad than other fossil fuels.
So what can we do? The shift away from natural gas needs to happen, both on the supply side and on the demand side. On the supply side, we must call for regulation to cease new approvals of gas drilling wherever possible. We must also build solidarity with grassroots pipeline resistance all around the world, including indigenous water protectors across North America. The demand side solutions start at home. Induction stoves, a newer and more efficient electric stove than the old resistance ones, heat quicker, get hotter, and are much safer than the gas stoves. Heat pumps are a hyper-efficient technology for heating the air and water in your home that are much safer and cheaper to run than gas furnaces. These two technologies are already affordable and available in many places, and would remove nearly all natural gas burning in buildings. If you can install these technologies, great, but even better is making your voice heard in your community. We should be demanding that our local and state governments incentivize these technologies and ban gas from new construction so that all electric becomes the cheapest option. Additionally, we should demand that our elected officials streamline the development of dense, multifamily, all-electric homes. Finally, we should demand federal spending to make sure that the cost of this transition is distributed in a way that doesn't further burden those most vulnerable populations to climate change.
The fight for climate justice must say no to natural gas. Nuclear plants will retire around the country in the next 10 years, and we need to demand that no new gas plants are built to fill the gaps. If we allow gas infrastructure to expand at this critical moment, we will not only fall behind other countries in the energy transition. By locking in more climate-altering fossil fuel infrastructure, we will be endangering all life on Earth. The natural gas industry is powerful, and the status quo can be hard to change. But together, we can get off of natural gas and onto a cleaner, healthier energy future.